can still hear some of it. This is dry grass, so this will eventually turn into hay. If it stays dry for long enough. Now, good drying conditions are warm weather. We have 12 degrees Celsius and a high wind. So we might be okay. Still have patches of weeds here. Now, because we're looking at dry grass on the mow, does mean that this will turn into hay if we leave it too long. If I want to make silage, I do not want my grass drying out to hay, because then it's useless as far as silage making is concerned. The hay texture is that yellow on the left. It's not straw, it's hay. I don't want to get too close to the edge, because then the mover will have problems. I don't want to be too far from the edge, because then I'm wasting grass. Now, if we get hay, we're going to have enough hay out of this. I'll be able to sell what I consider to be excess hay immediately. Put some of it in storage in the barn at the entrance. Will allow me to consider buying cattle before winter's out. I think I may be wrong, but I think the time to breed cows is spring. So I probably want to leave off buying dairy cows until spring. This is going to be a better yield than last time, because we dealt with a lot of the weeds and we also managed to get this land fully fertilised. When it comes to mowing for silage, what I'll do is I'll have one of our other tractors hitched up to the windrower, probably the vent, and put the loading wagon on our other heavy tractor, so that we're collecting as we mow and there's no chance of it drying. course, the other option is that you can consider making silage. Because the ground was wet first thing this morning, is to cut it while it's wet, and that grass will never dry out unless you turn it. And then later in the day, cut for hay. As it is, I'm hoping the conditions are good enough that this will dry out, because if it doesn't dry out, then it's going to end up in a silage bunker. Goal is hay. I don't want to leave it overnight because chances are there will be dew in the morning and that will turn the grass wet. Which would then need to be tedded and attempted to dry again. Don't think that's going to happen. If we can't get it dry today, we'll probably not get it dry tomorrow either. And grass does decay from after the first midnight. So we want this dried and baled before tonight, or it will start going away. Sort of job. I could do this with GPS. I believe I've loaded GPS onto both heavy tractors. I don't think I bothered with the harvester. The reason for that is this sort of job you can do it by eye for the most part. And it doesn't matter if you overlap and go over areas you've been before. Whereas with fertilizer and seed, you kind of need to pay attention because otherwise you can waste some. That's costly. Can't be. Mowing this field. Probably drive back to the yard. Oh, the other field's down the bottom of the hill, so I don't need this set up here anymore. Just have to keep an eye on how on the condition of the grass. Yeah. hay we didn't collect last time will be, still available for this time. It'll hang around until it rains and then it'll go away. Also, because we're baling hay and collecting loose grass, we're not going to end up with interference with leftover materials in the baler. The only reason we ended up with grass in the baler when we created the straw bales was because we did some baling contracts which involved making silage bales or wrapped grass bales technically. And so we had some leftover grass in the baler. The straw too just becomes a grass bale. Okay. Very interesting. Wish we could have would be a fixed third person view, so I could adjust the angle for the vehicle and it would stay at that whether I was going up or downhill. The problem here is I'm going to turn around and I'm going to go downhill, and the camera view is coming from right behind the vehicle. So if I lift it back up to my preferred turn around and go up the hill, it's going to be too high. And the same on if I'm running along the side of a hill. Tips this way, I'm right behind the tractor. And when I turn around, it tips the other way, so I'm positioned left of the tractor. Okay, so one grass field to cut and dry. Oops. Looks like it has a tree. Okay, so I'm going to need to do that bit there. Got mist. This is top of the field. In relation to the island is going to have to get done again. Did you stop or are you doing things? And you have finished, have you? I don't believe you. It's actually good. Okay. So the reason he didn't do the bottom was because field comes in and then goes out. I drove past that a bit, that's my fault. We still have 1900 litres of seed on board, so that's going to see us easily we'll seed radish two more of our fields, if not all of them. I'm going to guess all of them get done on this load. But then we are going to need to go to the store and buy some seed for our crop next year. DLC loaded. I don't have any use for it right this minute. Yeah, I could make hay pellets, but I really can't afford the equipment. I really don't have the equipment to haul it. If the map was flat, probably. Gradients on this map, no chance that we're going to get that previous 500 gold behind either of these big tractors. Okay, so let's drive along here and see what we're sniffing before. So it's got done fairly well. Over to our right, and then a big strip onto our left, towards where the Zarian is, the accent is. So pull it up here. Easy right turn to get me out of there. Tight right turn. The direction is to get to the other bit. Right there. I think my mind now is the correct speed for this. Not too bad here. I'll keep the tractor as far to the right as I can. Hello, good morning, afternoon, and welcome to the stream. How is your Saturday? State of house arrest that we all find ourselves under. Since these edges are now all workers, should be able to keep this fairly accurate. Mars Leo, good afternoon and welcome to the stream. Okay, I think what I'll do here, I'll do a loop around the island. So I'm gonna guess the worker didn't get all of it. Oh, maybe he did. Oh no, there's a bit there and a bit there. I think I am not precise enough to get an exact width there on the way back down. So there'll be a very thin area I'm planted. We'll have to get on another climb. Precisely, I can get this set. Drop and drive. This does look fairly accurate. Oh, we missed. Okay. Somewhere here, I missed a bit right there. Very, very narrow strip right there, which said I'd probably be left over. There we go. We have a seeded field, which will, in a couple of days, look as disgustingly green as that one there ahead of us. 1,800 litres of seed, that's good. Well, that's unfortunate. Let's have to see the back of the following tractor. Okay then. Guess we can fix that. Oh, stop. Following tractor. That's 26.3 hours. Still kind of want to bias towards using the Challenger for a while. Thank you. again, stop, 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 stop. Don't hit me. Ooh. A little bit close, but we got away with it. Try and break this one and then turn onto the grass. We've got that grass field behind those trees still to do today.
Welcome to your challenger.
Back up a bit, and hard left turn. Me. So, seriously, I'm having problems with. There we go. So for a long cedar, this actually isn't that bad. It's a little bit wide, but it is fairly easy to maneuver it around this yard in spite of everything, although I do park it in the lower lot. Issues with this gate sometimes. And for those of you late to the show, this is our animal trailer. It fixes to the back of our flatbed. The big red one that looked like a mowing trailer up by the silos. Okay. That might be in the door. Thank you. So I'm done planting around seed radish until after my next harvest, so pull that forward, jump out. Expanding the yard into that field as we need to. Right now, we are done with this. I'm going to need to bale, I'm going to need to regrow. And we're going to need to regrow and we're going to need to collect. Oh, I'm going to need to collect. Up to the top. I'm not gonna put the challenger on this though. probably end up hitching the Valtra to this trailer when we're ready. Doesn't have a particularly high horsepower requirement. No point in wasting engine power and cost of maintenance running a big tractor when I don't need to. Yeah, it's one of the reasons why I've got that extension at the bottom. In Farm Sim 17, it was a purchasable section of land that was listed as sort of ready for sort of development. It wasn't specified as a grass field or arable field. It was designed as perfectly flat ground for you to put placeables in Farm Sim 17. But it wasn't part of the initial farm allocation, so you had to buy it. There is another one, if I remember rightly. I think it was this field here was also classed as an placeable expansion. Now we have to buy it, but it's not a field number, it's just a plot of land. We can actually go and look at it by jumping to the piggies and crossing the road. Where's the road? Up there. Get run over, jump. Was it this here or was it the next one down? I don't recall, but there was a field here that was very small and just designed for placeables. Looks like a piece of forestry here. Actually, useless forestry. Yeah, that's not very flat. That field in there is very flat. Quite flattish. So you could use this to put placeables on. For example, straw harvest DLC. Or straw harvest add-on. And the access to this field was from the parking lot in the pub. Is that a pub? I thought it was a pub. Seven Springs. So anyway, yeah. The original map was designed with placeable expansion. And I'm going to move that out. Ready to go. So we have a reminder of what else we need to do before things need to start happening. So if I get out later this morning, what is the time? It's 9 o'clock game time. We'll take this down to the soybean fields and spray them for weeds. And then we can bring that tractor back, put regular or wide tyres on it, and initially we'll hitch it up to the loading wagon. I think once we're done with the grass and silaging, I may drop the lease on the Fendt, save us some money, because that is horrendously expensive to run. And we'll use the Valtra for carting purposes for the rest of the year. And next year, if we need to, we can put narrow tyres back on it. But I'm hoping we won't need to. Or if we do have to, we're just going to be running herbicide around the field and done. There's the dog. Oh. Hi, dog. And okay, I can't throw. I throw like a girl. There we go. Oh, he's hungry. Okay, well, the ball just went through the wall, so we've seen the last of that. We'll fill the sheep up again. It's like seriously going through a lot of water lately. As I said, don't know how long it's going to take for the grass to dry. See, I'll take hay pellets now. That, I'm going to let that run lower. So probably not get to feeding them hay until tomorrow. But we now have 66 sheep to be going on with. Oh, I didn't check. Ah, hello. We have pregnant sheep. Yay. Oh, and some of the new ones are. So this is the time of year to buy your sheep. What is today? 2nd of autumn? Yeah. So early fall. But we didn't buy them first day of early fall. If you're running a 3-day season, buy them first day. Actually, buy sheep first day, because that way they're in the slot ready to go. And then they have 0.4 of a year, so we should be seeing baby sheep appearing in spring. But that's good, because that means we're going to end up with a lot of new sheep for next year. Anyway, I need some food. It's now 1:15 real time on the east coast of the United States, and other places within that time zone. And for now, I'm going to say thank you for watching. Have fun, and I'm out of here.